Back now at 7:43 with what one family is calling a deadly case of workplace bullying. The editor of a Virginia magazine is now under investigation by university officials for allegedly driving one of his employees to suicide. NBC's Jeff Rawson is here with details on that. Jeff, good morning.
Hi, Matt. Good morning. If you've ever had a bully for a boss, you know how stressful it can be. But at this office in Virginia, coworkers say their boss was so mean, so toxic, that employee actually killed himself just to escape. He'd gone to human resources and other officials more than a dozen times for help, but his boss remained on the job.
Inside this small Virginia office, Kevin Morrissey was reaching his breaking point, dealing with a boss who coworkers say taunted him endlessly. Kevin worked for a campus magazine at the University of Virginia called VQR, Virginia Quarterly Review. Remarkable. Kevin's sister told us he lived for his job and ended up dying for it.
He was really good at his job, and no one should have to choose between a bully boss and being unemployed.
That bully boss, as she put it, is Ted Genoways, the magazine's senior editor. Coworkers say Genoways harassed Kevin, blaming him for almost everything, even suspending Kevin for a week in mid-July without ever giving a reason, just to mess with him, one coworker told us.
Was it toxic?
It was a toxic environment for Kevin, absolutely.
Waldo Jaquith is the magazine's web editor.
Ted's treatment of Kevin in the last 2 weeks of his life was just egregious, and it just ate Kevin up.
Then, on the morning of July 30th, a final blow. Genoways sent Kevin this email, criticizing his work again. Kevin Morrissey received this email from his boss at 9:47 a.m. By 11:30, less than 2 hours later, he had come here to this coal tower near campus. Kevin called 911 to report a shooting. That's when he pulled out a gun, pulled the trigger, and killed himself.
It was just like, I can't take it anymore. You know, it's just the last straw.
While he battled with clinical depression, in his suicide note, Kevin blamed his boss, Ted Genoways, for driving him over the edge. I can't bear things anymore, he wrote. In his apartment, friends found the book he was reading, Working with the Self-Absorbed, How to Handle Narcissistic Personalities on the Job. But they say the most disturbing of all was his latest phone bill obtained by NBC News, showing Kevin made 17 calls to university offices in the week leading up to his death.
And what did they do for him?
Nothing. They said a lot of really great things, but no action ever resulted.
University officials confirmed they set up meetings, but Genoways remained in his position. In an email to the staff, Genoways defended himself and blamed Kevin. His work suffered, and his demeanor, to my mind, was often unacceptable for the workplace. I cannot accept the final blame he laid on me. Genoways declined to speak with us on camera, but his lawyer did.
You've heard the accusations.
Was your client a workplace bully?
Ted Genoways was not a workplace bully.
Does Ted take any responsibility for this?
When Kevin Morrissey committed suicide, it was some combination of unhappiness at work and his own long-standing clinical depression.
But for Kevin's family, if Genoways wasn't the cause, he was, in their words, the final straw.
With ongoing daily assaults and you're already depressed, how tough is that?
The University of Virginia admits no wrongdoing here, but they have launched a full internal investigation into Kevin's death, the workplace environment of the magazine, and allegations, Matt, that they did not act fast enough when Kevin reached out for help.
All right, Jeff, thank you very much. Nicole Williams is a career and workplace expert. Nicole, good morning to you.
Good morning, Matt.
Let's say right off the bat, the university needs to conduct an investigation. I'm going to let that happen.
Yes.
I'm not going to jump to any conclusions. What does jump out at me, though, is the number of phone calls that were made by Kevin to university officials in the days or weeks leading up to this.
Yeah, no. And you know what's so funny, Matt, is bullying is rampant. There's no question about it. And because it's not illegal, right? It's not considered harassment unless the individual being bullied is under protected status and the person who's actually doing the bullying is not part of that protected status
right.
group. So a lot of times this goes on, people complain repeatedly, and officials do not respond appropriately.
But I mean, if there are repeated complaints, mm-hmm. clearly it's a he said, she said situation,
yeah.
or in this case, he said, but does the university need to at least separate these two while they're conducting a further investigation?
Yes. Yes, you'd think so. Yes, Matt, absolutely. The way that this is dealt with, and of course we're going to learn more as time goes on, sounds as if this was a very, you know, tragic case that was not handled well. But, you know, it is true there's bullying going on without question. I think that this is a great opportunity for us to reflect on why is bullying so rampant and how are we going to deal with it.
What is bullying? I mean, what defines workplace bullying? You can be a tough boss without being a bully in the workplace. So what's the difference?
Yeah, it's repeated, Matt, and it's very, it's all about undermining someone. It is about, and this is the problem with bullying, is sometimes it's very covert. It's very passive-aggressive. It's gossiping about people. It's not letting them into important meetings. You know, it's treating them meanly and poorly, but you're right. It's tough. What's the difference between the tough boss
but
and someone
Kevin Morrissey also had a history of clinical depression, and that may have influenced the way that officials viewed this. They may have thought this was something more in line with his depression and less in line with what was going on in the workplace.
Absolutely.
Again, we don't know, but there's
an
investigation underway.
And it's so chicken and egg, Matt, because, you know, inevitably, you're bullied at work, you are going to be depressed. You know, at what point is the bullying responsible for his depression and obviously his, you know, unfortunate suicide? This is a really interesting case and definitely is going to bring light to there's, you know, workplace, healthy workplace bill that's out and about, and certainly this is going to definitely bring some interest to this kind of topic. Yes.
Nicole Williams. Nicole, thanks.